Volcanoes National Park was established in 1925. It is home not only to gorillas, but also golden monkeys. They also feed on the bamboo, which grows from 2,500 to 3,200 metres. Apart from bamboo, these monkeys have been known to feed on leaves, fruit and insects. They are similar in appearance to the blue Sykes monkey, save for their golden colouring. However, there is debate as to whether they are strictly a subspecies of that monkey. They live in groups of up to 30 individuals. Unfortunately, they are listed as endangered. The main threats to them have been loss of habitat and the wars that have plagued the region. Even the park headquarters were attacked in February 1992. Two employees were killed. The Park and Research Centre, opened by Diane Fossey originally, reopened in June 1993, but less than a year later had to be closed again because of the genocide. Apart from a brief period in 1995, the park didn't reopen again until 1999. The extent to which all of this has affected the biodiversity in the park can only be guessed at. Surveys have been limited, but it's believed that the park has less diversity than the equivalent areas in Uganda. Once the monkeys came out of the forest and into a clearing, it was possible to appreciate the full splendour of their coats. The troop is habituated to humans, and it didn't take long to find them. It was an easy trail through agricultural land to reach the park boundary, which was marked by a wall. Thereafter, the monkeys were only half an hour's walk away, through flat land, through a bamboo forest. The ease with which we saw these monkeys belies the difficulty in habituating them. That was not even commenced until 2002 and was initially fraught with difficulty. For long periods, the monkeys would flee at the first sight of the observers. However, the observers persevered, and in the summer of 2003, tourists began to track these monkeys. 3 years later, a leading guidebook to the area commented on how they were still difficult to spot and elusive. By the time I got there in 2009, this had all changed. While spotting the monkeys had been a little tricky in the forest owing to its denseness, even here the monkeys were entirely comfortable with the presence of the tourists. In the clearing which they occupied for most of the 1 hour we were permitted to observe them, the sightings could not have been better. Trekking the monkeys had proved very easy. The following day, I was to trek the gorillas. This proved very challenging. I was to see Group 13. It is led by a silverback named Agashia. The group gets its name from the fact that when it was founded, there were 13 individuals. There are now some 26. Like the Rushagura group I had seen in Uganda, these gorillas have been known to relocate out of the country. Despite this, it has been suggested, on the basis of recent DNA studies, that the gorilla population in the Virunga Mountains is genetically different from that in Burundi. It is now believed that, despite the geographical links in the area, they have been breeding separately for many millennia. In due course, therefore, there may be said to be two subspecies of mountain gorilla. Studies have also been done into the diet of these gorillas. They eat some 58 different species of plant in the Virunga Mountains, with bamboo being the most popular. Insects are also eaten, and of these, ants are the preferred food. Thank you. While the gorillas that were feeding pretty much ignored us, that was not true of some juveniles. They came right up behind us. They were very curious indeed. Their presence attracted the attention of the silverback, forcing us to back off quietly. Once we had done so, he turned his back on us and resumed feeding. The juveniles seemed much more interested in playing than in feeding, and they provided us with a great deal of entertainment. The gorilla tracking marked the end of our time in Rwanda. We had a long journey by road to Kigali that afternoon for our evening flight back to Uganda. We were met once again by Joel and taken to Kasubi Base Camp. After a free day there, it was time to return to the United Kingdom. I left thinking there was much more I would like to see of both countries. Nevertheless, what I had seen had been immensely enjoyable.